Hey everyone, Stacey Wallace here with Warrior DNA, where we're redefining the F word: faith, family, finance, fitness, and freedom. Yesterday we weren't able to do a Warrior DNA because we had some really precious people around that we were happy to support in our home. But today we are taking some very interesting current events and looking at how they relate to our biblical success strategies. Now, let me just give you a quick warning. I'm going to talk about some political things here, and I don't think as Christians we should identify with a political party. I really do believe that we should be identified by our faith. If you're following a political party and it does not follow the Word of God, then you need to really question what it is you're standing up for. I'm not Democratic. I'm not Republican. I vote according to the Word of God, and I'm very passionate about that. So one of the things that I've noticed, a couple of things that in today, obviously, we see a lot of cynical, angry, mob-like people who are picketing, rioting. We're hearing hate-filled words. Women that are saying that they're representing all women. I'm just telling you today, I do not believe that an angry woman represents a biblical woman. I can have people and offenses that have happened in my life, and still I can choose to be angry and not sin. And I want to talk today about what we really need in our society, especially as women right now. You know, I labeled this, we need a riot. I want to talk about keeping it on the rails, keeping it in the between the gutters. You know, I recently went and I played bowling. I guess you play bowling. I went bowling with my family, and I was really shocked that we had like 13 of us, and I was able to be the number two bowler. I mean, I kept hitting strike after strike after strike. It was amazing. I don't know how I did it. I think it's because I played Wii bowling so long with my kids when they were little. But while we were bowling, it was interesting because there were a couple of little kids that were having some challenges. So they put up these, I guess they were called gutter guards, and they were to protect the ball from going in the gutter. And you know, I started thinking that that is a lot like what the Word of God is to us, to keep us from going in the gutter, the cesspool of an angry mob, whether it's Republicans or Democrats. We can quickly lose our reflection of Christ when we begin to be like the crowd or get angry like the crowd, or all of a sudden we're the people screaming at Jesus, "Crucify him!" And we forget, what are we fighting for? We're fighting for peace. We're fighting for love. We're fighting for life. If you are right now fighting for something that murders babies and that hurts people and that defames people, it's not about a political party. It's not about what that party stands for. It's about truly standing up for the Word of God. And I know this isn't a popular thing that a lot of people are going to stand up and be bold, but this last week when we did the March for Life, the Hike for Life, I couldn't help but remember a vision years and years ago, a sweet, precious, what I would call spiritual mama of the faith for a lot of people, Reba Rambo McGuire. I believe it was either she or I had a vision. I think she had the vision of walking out of one of the concerts, and they were beautiful musicians, worship leaders, and did a lot of concerts. We traveled on the bus with them. And she came out of the concert, got in the bus, and started sharing this vision about walking out, and there were a ton of aborted babies on the outside of this Coliseum. And I remember then, and I remember this morning as I was thinking about what we would talk about with Warrior DNA and this idea of keeping it between the gutters, keeping ourselves out of the gutter of life, keeping ourselves on the tracks of the Holy Spirit, tracks of the Word of God. How do we do that? Well, that day when she talked about the babies being the vision that she had, that's the same thing as what happens when we go to church. People raise their hand for Christianity, but they're never taught how to keep it out of the gutters. And so what do? There's inception of Christianity, but there's not the maturity of the body of Christ. And that is called abortion in the spirit. When we have conception without mobilization and maturation, that's abortion. And so these natural, supernatural things that are taking place in the world around us, it's not so that we become hateful and angry, but it's so that we awaken and say, are we really reflecting God's word? Are we really reflecting the love of God? Are we really reflecting the truth of God's word? You know, there was, of course, the McGregor fight. I don't know if you guys watched it, if you're UFC followers, but I didn't watch it, but I watched the replays. And here we have a hateful argument. I mean, these guys are warring at each other. There's a fierce battle of egos between them. And, of course, McGregor goes down. McGregor loses. And what was interesting is, even though that is a caged fight, the fight didn't stay in the caged. It got outside of the gutter. It got off track when one of the fighters, I can't even say his name, jumped the fence or jumped the cage and went after one of the guys, one of his trainer, McGregor's trainers. The point is after it was all over, McGregor said, the fight might be over, but this fight will never end. Well, you know what? We need a riot, a righteous invasion of truth. Carmen Licardello is a really amazing singer and evangelist, still traveling today. He had a song, We Need a Riot, a righteous invasion of truth. And I believe today, wherever you're at in your heart, today's Warrior DNA is dedicated to help you think twice about what you're arguing about. Think twice about what you're fighting for and say, am I being a living, breathing, walking reflection of the truth of God's word? You know, the truth of God's word is very clear, that we are to love our neighbors as ourselves. You know, that we war not against flesh and blood or policies or procedures or parties, but we war against principalities. Right now, more than ever before, when I turn on the TV and I see women and men hatefully arguing and screaming vile things against other human beings, I realize we don't war against flesh and blood, but that's a principality called Jezebel that's here to divide and separate the body of Christ. We've got Christians fighting against Christians. What is that? That's a Jezebel spirit that's coming with a narcissistic, I'm right, the law doesn't apply to me, I'm gonna fight, I'm not gonna respect authorities. That Jezebel spirit has to be stopped. So how will it be stopped? It's gonna be stopped by a riot. A righteous invasion of truth. It's going to be stopped when we stop trying to blend into the world and be politically acceptable, and we start standing up for the love and the truth of God's word. It's going to be when we start to be anointed by God to lay hands on the sick and they recover, when our power of Christ and our power of the Holy Spirit is really more powerful than Harry Potter. When we stop running after the things of the paranormal that's being offered by the world, and we start running after the supernatural truth of God's word. When we do that, we're going to begin to see a shift take place in the world around us. God wants you to be unleashed and anointed for business, but you're not going to be unleashed because of your talents, your giftings, or your banter of words. You're going to be unleashed because of the power of the Holy Spirit, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. I pray today that as you get all up in other people's businesses and you're listening, like I said last week, be a thermostat, not a thermometer, and let yourself truly every day ask yourself, what I'm fighting for? Am I fighting for the word of God, or am I trying to hold up my ego and my opinion? Sometimes it's better just to give up your right to be right, so that the truth of God's word can shine through you. I hope that you'll share this. I'm sure it'll create a little bit of good banter between you and your friends. Be bold, be strong, be courageous. And remember, you're a warrior with a DNA of the Holy Spirit. Have a great day, everybody. Peace out.